first, though, to house prices and how remarkably healthy those prices are in these pandemic times. Today, the news that house prices have hit an all-time high.
Economists had been predicting falls, but the opposite has happened. So, where are the biggest gains? Here's Carolyn Robinson.
It seems nothing is going to plan in 2020. Even house prices are going off script. They were predicted to fall, but instead they've done the exact opposite. And they're not just rising, they're hitting record highs. Every single region is up. Auckland by 16% with a new median house price of $950,000. But it's not the North Island's biggest winner. That honour goes to Hawke's Bay. Prices there up a whopping 20.1%. On the mainland, Southland takes the top spot. Homes there up an eye-watering 20.3% to 373,000. New Zealand's new national median is now $675,000. That's up from $580,000 a year ago. But why is it happening? And how long will it last?
And here to talk us through the figures is Bindi Norwell from the Real Estate Institute of New Zealand. Thanks for joining us, Bindi. Are you surprised by these record highs?
Thanks for having me on. Yes, I am. I'm quite surprised. We've had record median prices in 8 regions, 17 districts, and this hasn't happened for quite some time. But also, volumes across the country, so the number of properties sold, increased by 25%, and this is the busiest August we've had in 5 years. So, yeah, very surprising.
Why are prices going up when we were told to expect the opposite?
Yeah, we were told there are a lot of expectations around this. Now, I think there's a number of reasons. We've had record low interest rates. We've had the removal of LVRs. Also, people wanting to move home from overseas. But really, people are really finding that investing in property at this time is a really good thing. It's a good, solid, long-term investment. So there's been a lot of activity around that.
Bindi, how much longer do you think it will go on?
It's a really good question. I would say that, you know, this time of year, it typically gets much busier when it gets warmer as well. And I think if interest rates go even lower, it may even support the market for even more. We just don't know, though. I mean, we don't know about unemployment and the effects of the economy. But I would say that at this stage, it looks like that there's a lot of activity and it's continuing.
It's clearly a good time to sell. What's your advice to those looking to buy?
Well, I think it's really making sure you do your homework and get good advice, good legal advice, talk to real estate agents, but fundamentally get good financial advice. I think so. So when you do find that property, you know exactly what you can afford and you're very well prepared.
Bindi Norwell, thank you so much for your time. Have a good weekend.
Thank you. You too.
ASB and 7 Sharp, keeping you one step ahead.
And I tell you what, it's not often that you say it's good for everybody. At the moment, the housing market and what's happening with the housing market, you'd have to say, is good for everybody. Good for people who own their own homes, good for people who are looking to sell their own homes, good for actually people entering the market as well because of low interest rates.
Well, the interest rates, honestly, when you've got the experts saying that interest rates are going to start with a 1 very shortly, it's mind-boggling.
Very exciting time.